Every single time government officials try and do things and hide it from the American people and then get caught doing what they're doing, they do the same thing. They scream the word terrorism over and over in the hope that people will get scared. It's just pure fear-mongering and agree that they should be able to do whatever they want. The reality is that nothing we exposed informed the terrorists of anything. The spying we exposed had nothing to do with terrorism. It was bulk collecting phone records, chats, emails of the American people indiscriminately. The only thing that we informed anybody of was not the terrorists, but the American people, that this spying apparatus built in the dark is aimed at them.
Why did he leave the U.S. in the first place? Why not stay here and fight? If he was really a hero, wouldn't he have just, you know, been seen a little differently if he'd have just stuck around and kind of stood his ground?
I don't think so. If you look at what Bradley Manning, for example, did, who leaked thousands of pages showing serious war crimes on the part of the United States, he didn't run, and yet most people in the media and lots of people in the United States viewed him as somehow an odious person, even a traitor. He's been locked away in a cage for many years, and we haven't heard from him. There's an op-ed by Daniel Ellsberg, who most people consider to be a heroic whistleblower, in the Washington Post from 2 weeks ago, who said that Snowden was right to flee, because unlike when Daniel Ellsberg was charged with leaking, he was able to be free during the trial. He was able to speak publicly. If in this country now, whistleblowers under the Obama administration are treated very harshly. If Mr. Snowden came back, he would be stuck in prison. He wouldn't be allowed to participate in the debate that he helped provoke, and it'd be very unlikely that he would get a fair trial. That's from Daniel Ellsberg in the Washington Post, who said that Snowden was right to leave the country.
In an interview with an Argentinian newspaper, you stated that Snowden had more to reveal. Your quote is, "The U.S. government should be on their knees every day praying that nothing happens to Snowden, because if something happens, all information will be revealed, and that would be their worst nightmare."
Right. That was, you know, before I began reporting this story, I wrote an article about how anybody who exposes what the U.S. government is doing is the target of smear campaigns and demonization. And that was a perfect example of how Reuters took that quote completely out of context. I made the exact opposite point as the one that Reuters and government defenders tried to claim that I made. That answer was in response to a question, which was, do you think the United States government will try and kill Mr. Snowden? And I said, that would make no sense. He has with him extremely sensitive documents that he has been insistent not be disclosed, because his goal is not to harm the United States, but to shed light to his fellow citizens on what the government is doing. And if he were killed, there'd be no telling how those documents would then get released, probably more irresponsibly. If I were the U.S. government, I would be praying for his health, not trying to kill him, because of how responsible of a whistleblower he's been in insisting that these stories be reported judiciously.